Ever feel like your projects are always behind the schedule? Today, we are using Pareto Front Analysis to track your project delays. In this video, we'll create and share a dynamic template in Excel with four easy steps. Analyzing project delay data in Excel, creating Pareto charts and visualizing major delay causes, interpretation of results and mitigating delays, and comparing delay analysis methods including time impact analysis or TIA and window analysis. You can follow along by getting the Excel workbook via the provided link in the description below.
Stefan is analyzing delay data in Excel.
Our case focuses on a simulation of Melbourne Airport Rail Link project, which has significant delays. First, we should organize our data on project delays. So in column A, we'll put the delay cause category. This could be anything specific to your project, including design errors, material delays, permitting or approvals, labor shortages, weather conditions, equipment breakdowns, and scope changes. Just like we have here, be as comprehensive as possible based on your project experience and data. Next, in column B, we are counting number of instances, which means how many times each type of delay happened. Column C is the average duration of each delay instance. And column D is total delay in days. This is simply calculated by multiplying number of instances by the average delay per instance. Just use the product formula in cell D3 and drag it down for all categories. This gives us the total delay contributed by each cause category. Now we need to sort this data by impact. We want to see which delay causes contribute most to our overall project delay. So select your entire data table, go to the data tab in Excel, and click sort. We are sorting by total delay with the order of largest to smallest. This rearranges our table, putting the delay categories with the biggest total delay at the top. The sorted order is the backbone to our Pareto front optimization. But we are not stopping there. To truly understand the cumulative impact, we are going to calculate two more columns: cumulative total delay in days and cumulative percentage of total delay. These will really help us visualize the 80-20 rule, which I'll explain later. In column E, we sort with the first value being the same as the first total delay value. So cell E3 will be equal to D3. Then for cell E4 and onwards, we are going to add the current row's total delay to the previous row's cumulative total. The formula in E4 will be E3 plus D4, and you just drag the formula down. Finally, column F, cumulative percentage of total delay, expresses our cumulative delay as a percentage of the grand total delay. First, find the grand total delay by summing up all the values in the total delay column in a separate cell like D10 by summing up D3 to D9. Then in cell F3, enter the formula E3 divided by D10. Make sure to use a dollar sign to make an absolute reference to D10 so it doesn't change when you drag the formula down. And just like that, step 1 is complete. We've entered our delay pure data, sorted it by impact, and calculated the cumulative totals and percentages. We've now laid the groundwork for our visual masterpiece, which is the Pareto chart.
Step 2 is creating Pareto charts and visualizing major delay causes.
We are going to create a Pareto chart, which is a special type of combination chart in Excel. It's going to combine columns and a line to give us that classic Pareto shape. To create our chart, we need to select three columns: delay cause category, total delay, and cumulative percentage of total delay. You can select these non-continuously. Just hold down the Ctrl key while selecting the three columns. Make sure you include the headers in your selection. Next, go to the Insert tab, click on the recommended charts, and choose clustered column. Now that's starting to look like a Pareto chart. We've got our columns showing the total delay for each cause nicely sorted from tallest to shortest. And we've got that rising line showing the cumulative percentage climbing towards 100%. But let's make it even clearer and more professional for our project reports. Remove unwanted elements and add access titles. Click on the chart, then click the plus icon to add chart elements. Under access titles, check primary vertical and secondary vertical. Now you can edit the titles for primary vertical access to total delay in days and the secondary vertical access to cumulative percentage of total delay. Next, you can format the access scales if needed to make sure the percentages go all the way to 100% and everything is easy to read. You can also modify access options and change the color of access bounds and titles to better animate project delay analysis. May I pause here for a minute and quickly mention something. Our analytics show that only around 30% of the channel's regular viewers are subscribed. If you are enjoying our content, don't forget to subscribe and turn on the notification bell. It's a free way to support us in continuing this learning journey. Thanks. Back to our template, and you can also add data labels to the columns or the line if you want the exact numbers right on the chart, but sometimes less is more. And there you have it, step 2 is complete. We have transferred our data to a visually insightful Pareto chart. Now let's decode what this chart is actually telling us in the next step.
Step 3 is interpretation of results and mitigating delays.
First, let's focus on columns. Remember, these columns represent the total delay in days for each delay cause category. And because we sorted our data, they are ordered from tallest to shortest, from left to right. The taller the column, the bigger the total delay impact of that cause category. Look at our chart, which columns are the tallest? In our example, it's clear. Scope changes, material delays, and permitting or approvals are towering above the rest. These are our vital few delay causes based on Pareto principles. These are the categories that are contributing the most significantly to our project delays. These are areas where we need to focus our attention, our resources, and our improvement efforts. Now let's look at the line. Remember that this line represents the cumulative percentage of total delay. It starts low and rises as we move from left to right across delay cause categories. The steepness of this line is crucial. A steep rise early on tells you that a relatively small number of causes are responsible for a large chunk of the total delay. Look at the point on the line roughly above permitting or approvals. In our example, it's around 58%. This is a huge insight. It tells us that just these first three delay causes of scope change, material delays, and permitting or approvals are already responsible for approximately 58% of the total project delay. Now look at the line as it moves towards the right. Notice how it starts to flatten out. This flattening indicates that adding more delay cause categories contributes less and less to the cumulative delay percentage. The categories on the right with the shorter columns are what we call the trivial many. They do contribute to delays, but their individual impact is much smaller compared to the vital few. This is the essence of Pareto analysis and the 80-20 rule in action. A smaller number of causes or the vital few are driving the majority of the effect on our project delays. It's not always exactly 80-20, but the principle holds true. A disproportionate impact comes from a small set of sources. You can also visually identify the knee of the curve or the point where the cumulative percentage line starts to flatten out. This point roughly separates the vital few from the trivial many. Everything to the left of the knee is your high impact zone, which we must focus there. So what do you do with this information? This Pareto analysis is a powerful prioritization tool. It tells us where to focus our efforts for maximum impact. Based on our example, the project manager should immediately prioritize these vital few. To mitigate project delays from scope changes, implement a robust change management process with clear approval protocols and impact assessments. You must maintain continuous stakeholder communication to align expectations and identify potential scope shifts early. Finally, use agile planning techniques to adapt schedules efficiently, while ensuring resource flexibility and risk contingencies are in place. To mitigate project time overruns from material delays, establish strong supplier relationships and diversify sources to reduce dependency on single vendors. Also implement just-in-time delivery with buffer stocks for critical materials and use real-time tracking system for improved supply chain visibility. You must conduct proactive risk assessments and include material lead times in project scheduling to anticipate and address potential disruptions. To mitigate project delays from permitting and approvals, engage regulatory authorities early on and maintain ongoing communication to understand requirements and timelines. You must allocate dedicated resources to manage documentation, track approval status, and promptly address feedback. Finally, incorporate permitting milestones into project schedule with contingency plans for potential delays. Remember, Pareto analysis doesn't mitigate the delays, but it's a diagnostic tool. It pinpoints the problem areas. It guides us to ask the right questions and focus problem-solving efforts where they have the greatest positive impact. By tackling the vital few delay causes, we can expect to see the most significant reductions in overall project delays. Step 3, or Pareto analysis interpretation, is all about understanding what your Pareto chart tells you, identifying the vital few and trivial many, and translating these insights into actionable recommendations for mitigating delays. Now in our final step, let's zoom out and see how Pareto analysis fits into the bigger picture of our project delay analysis toolkit.
Step 4 is comparing delay analysis methods, including time impact and window analysis.
Pareto analysis is fantastic for identifying causes and prioritizing actions, but it's not the only tool in the project delay analysis toolbox. Let's quickly compare it to some other common methods you might encounter in project management. These methods often focus on quantifying and assessing responsibility for delays, while Pareto analysis is more about understanding the landscape of delay causes. First up, the simplest approach is as planned versus as built. This method basically compares your original project schedule or as planned to what actually happened or as built. It's great for a high-level overview as you can easily see the total project delay, but it's very limited since it doesn't tell you why there were delays or their causes. It's a simple comparison of start and finish dates and maybe major milestones. It's visually helpful to show the extent of delays but not the reasons. Next, we have time impact analysis, or TIA. This is a more sophisticated and forward-looking method. TIA analyzes the impact of discrete delay events as they occur. Imagine a sudden material delay. TIA assesses how this specific event ripples through the schedule and impacts subsequent tasks and the overall completion date. It's suitable for analyzing the impact of specific changes and can be used to support extension of time claims. However, TIA can be complex and relies heavily on accurate schedule logic. Also, TIA can be subjective depending on how delay events are modeled. Then there is window analysis. This method breaks a project down into periods or windows of time. Within each window, you analyze what actually happened and attribute delays to different parties. Window analysis is helpful in handling concurrent delays, where both the contractor and owner have contributed to delays in the same period. However, it can become complex and data intensive, and defining the windows themselves can be subjective and influence the outcome. Next up is collapse as build, which is a retrospective method. You start with the as-built schedule, which is a record of what actually happened. Then you hypothetically remove all the contractor responsible delays. The difference between this collapsed schedule and the original as planned schedule theoretically represent the owner caused delays. It's strong for isolating delay responsibility, but reconstructing the collapsed schedule can be challenging and open to interpretation, especially if records are incomplete. Impact as planned is another method that tries to quantify the impact of delay. It calculates delay by assuming each delay event occurred exactly as initially planned in the schedule. This sounds simple, but it's often criticized for being too theoretical and not accurately reflecting the dynamic and often chaotic reality of project execution, where delays rarely happen in isolation. Finally, we have contemporaneous period analysis. This is a very proactive approach. You analyze delays as they happen during defined periods throughout the project. This allows for real-time delay management and documentation, which is great for dispute resolution and proactive project control. However, it requires robust real-time data tracking systems and therefore data-intensive and time-consuming to implement effectively. So the final question is, where does Pareto analysis fit in? Pareto analysis is a cost tracking and prioritization method. Its strengths are its simplicity, visual power to communicate the relative contribution of different causes, and its focus on strategic decision-making. Think of Pareto analysis as the primary step. It helps you quickly identify what to investigate further. As an example in our project, once you know that scope changes are major causes of delay, you might then use a more detailed method like TIA or window analysis to quantify the specific delay impact of scope changes on your project timeline and then assign responsibility. Pareto analysis is your strategy compass and shows you where the analytical deep dive needs to begin. It's a fantastic tool in your project delay toolkit, especially for understanding the bigger picture of delay causes and prioritizing your improvement efforts. And that wraps up our implementation of Pareto analysis for project delays. I hope you can now see how powerful and surprisingly simple this tool is to implement in Excel. Try it out on your own projects and you'll be amazed at the uncovered insights.
If you found this video useful, please consider subscribing. You can get the Excel workbook by the provided link in the description below. I'll see you in the next one.